Hey guys, and welcome to Kelly Slater's Pro Surfer.
Oh yeah.
One of the few surfing games for the Xbox, PS2. You might have had Trans World Surf, you might have had Surfing H3O, or you might have had... Yeah?
I just want to say this is also for GameCube, because that's what I played as a kid. Can't forget the GameCube.
It's part of Activision's O2 lineup, so along with Sean Palmer, Pro Snowboarder, Matt Hoffman, Pro BMX... I think, and probably one I'm missing, but you know, part of their whole not skateboarding but extreme sports lineup.
Yeah.
So if you've seen those or if you've played those, you know the mechanics of this game. You know, well, you got good.
I was just gonna say this game isn't as extreme. I mean, it's only so extreme you can make surfing.
Yeah, it's sort of more chill of a game, especially the soundtrack. You know, you're not gonna be riding along to Godsmack and Disturbed here. Gonna be riding along to, I don't know, kind of like wave music.
Those faces are beautiful.
These faces.
Oh,
yeah.
God.
So weird. But, so we've got all these surfers with all these stapled on faces, and we're about to welcome a new name into the halls of greatness, Donovan Frankenrider.
Yeah, I always played as him because of his awesome hippie.
Frankenrider, man.
That is totally his Martin sitting on the couch.
Yeah. So, I've already left out a few things like the intro to the game, and then there's some little speech by Kelly Slater before this menu, and I'm gonna be leaving out the like intros to the levels. You know, like in Matt Hoffman 2, there were little film clips before each. I'm leaving those out because they're pretty long, and if they're not long, they're just tedious to sit through.
Honestly, we had a couple people watching the stream. We tried streaming the first time, and we streamed a little bit of this. And holy shit, Kelly Slater is boring.
Kelly Slater is not a public speaker.
He's so boring.
Yeah. He's too chill.
I like it when he's talking about the Wave House. He's like, the Wave House, it's not what I'm used to doing. It's
Sebastian.
Actually kind of dangerous. Yeah. It's kind of...
Back when I was 10, you know, there used to be five or so guys all competing for the same wave, you know. The water's great out here. So...
Hey, I was like the Indiana Jones map travel.
When I was 15, my mother died, and when she died, it was a real tragedy, as you can probably tell from my voice and how well I'm evoking sadness. That's the emotion that I'm feeling right now.
What does that plane say on the background? Oh, Kelly Slater's
Pro Surfer. It says Kelly Slater's Pro Surfer.
Does it?
So,
a real imaginative.
It's a surfing game. You've got a giant wave that acts like a half pipe, and...
To sort of simplify
things, you can ride up it and do tricks in the air, or you can do tricks like on the wave. You know, you can carve back and forth. There's a lot of like surfer lingo. You know, people who surf will probably understand this game a lot more than.
Do
you know what the Grom is?
Oh man, you don't know what the Grom is? Everyone knows what the Grom is.
Oh, I see. What's the Grom?
You're gonna need to figure it out on your own.
Oh, okay? is that what it is?
Yeah.
Are you sure? Yeah. Maybe you just don't know what the Grom is either?
If you don't know what the Grom is, then you'll need to figure it out on your own.
Well, yeah, you can do this thing and you have the weird balance bar.
So yeah, you can go into the wave, and this wave is too small, so I can't do tricks in it, but the waves get bigger and you do tricks in those, so.
And then you do the mad tricks. I was about to say that, goddammit.
If it's not obvious, this is the episode where I get to sound like I don't give a shit.
So it's a competent game, you know. It's like, again,
it's probably it's a lot better than like other surfboarding games that were out, because I played them, and this is the best looking, best playing one.
I mean, you know, again, it's part of Activision's lineup, and they made those were all competent. Might not have been standout, might have been a little boring at times, but they were competently done. It's just that this game, it's really technical, actually. Because
it is.
I don't know, riding up the wave, you know, the wave's always moving, the camera's always moving. It's not like your camera's behind the guy as he goes off ramps. And so at least I kind of have quite a bit of trouble, because it seems like I always run into the wave and wreck or don't land correctly, even though I'm pretty sure.
Well,
you know, once again, the camera I mean, I've tried switching the camera to the to all the other
options,
and none of them are better than the default. So yeah, you just kind of have to go with that.
Well, the real trick to just getting a lot of points in this game, I found, was just to do a bunch of, I guess you just call them, manuals, and then perform a special, and then manual some more, and then perform another special.
Yeah.
I mean, you can actually get a good combo going if you manual and then trick and then trick and then manual back and forth.
Yeah. I think.
But really, the... I mean.
Go ahead.
I was just going to say, it's just a matter of, like, being able to do a lot of things.
Yeah, I think the carving and sort of the manualing type of stuff, that never seems to be really be too reliable with me, because, you know, sometimes you just turn, and sometimes you do tricks, and sometimes you do a trick, and then you, like, lose control of your guy, or the wave just starts taking you somewhere that wrecks you.
Are you, like, holding down the button and everything? Just whipping around?
I don't know. I'll have to.
That was pretty swag, right?
I'll have to, like, pay close attention next time. But
it's. I mean, it. You know. No, like I said, I was never, like, the best at this game. I just enjoyed. It's a very pretty looking game for a GameCube, PS2, Xbox game.
Now,
I mean, you can see the boats and the sun and stuff.
Yeah. Another thing you can see is. The endless ocean out there, which apparently when you were a kid used to give you the shits.
Yeah, I don't...
Used to piss your pants a little.
Look, there's the ground. See the land right over there? See that mountain?
I don't have a problem with it now, probably because I'm focusing on trying to, like, not wreck all over the place.
Also because you're wearing
women's pants. Yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, looking out into the open ocean used to kind of scare me a little bit.
I thought
that would be, like, a real problem.
The world's big.
Yeah, you're so small. The world is so big.
Well, that's just how the world works, bro.
Dude, you know what's funny?
You're
really
the wave, and oh my god, did you just?
Yeah, he just kicked that guy's ass.
Yeah, we take out those winds.
Good.
You know, I find it funny. I find it funny that you choose to play as Don Frankenreiter, and he was the only person I would ever play as a kid. I would not play as anyone else.
Because of his name.
Because of his name and his awesome mustache and awesome hair.
He's got
the hippie swag, like I said.
Oh yeah,
he looks like a surfer, you know.
Yeah. Sometimes the wave breaks from the left and the right, and I'm like, okay, what the hell do I do? Because you can't exactly go into it. So, I mean, it's hard to articulate, but it really does seem like, at least I seem to have a lot of trouble linking things together. Partly because the way, to anyone who hasn't played this game, the way to really get combos going is you have to have your special bar all the way up, so it's glowing yellow, and then your combo just won't end until that goes back down or runs out. So, I mean, here I sort of get into a groove, but that's because, you know, I'm doing 180 air tricks.
Yes.
You know,
a lot of groove, man.
Someone who is good could, you know, probably, like, carve all over the place
take them out.
Go back into the barrel and do
was
the
a
cool
chick.
Stuff there.
This was a guy in a bikini.
Yeah, but I don't know. I feel like I just get wrecked.
You know, are you going to try and play through all the levels? Because I don't know if you want me to spoil this or not.
Don't spoil.
All right, I won't then.
I'm like 5 or 6 levels in, but
all right, in that case, I won't.
So, again, if you haven't played afterwards, you saw that these two levels, they looked like they had 5 goals. Well, that was just one set of goals.
Yeah.
Now that I've completed some of the goals, previous levels will get more goals. Each level has 2 sets. So, I was originally planning this video to be, like, the two sets on the first 2 levels, but I didn't know how long this would run, especially because with all the stuff I've cut out, again, at this point my recording was like 15 minutes long, mm-hmm. So I'll plan to do at least 2 sets
of
in
stuff,
a video.
Yeah.
Not necessarily 2 levels, I mean I might do these 2 sets
two,
and then
yeah,
go,
two
up,
events
go up to the third area and do both of those. So again, I'll just kind of have to work with it, especially to see if I can get better at it, because... The guide on GameFAQs, the guy is apparently super good or something, because he's,
yeah,
like, talking down to you the entire time.
I've seen him.
But, like, I look on YouTube, I look up Kelly Slater, and there's no one, there aren't any videos of someone who's good at this game. Everyone else is, like, falling all over the place and such, and really, it is pretty tough. I mean, I'd say, you know, again, like Matt Hoffman, Tony Hawk, most of the games before I've been able to pick up pretty easily. It feels like I'm still kind of having the same problems.
Yeah, like, if you before. Read the, if you read, like, any professional review for this game, they all say, this is a very difficult game, it's, like, extremely hard.
Yeah.
It's hard, I mean, it's
my
it's
first
no bullshit.
Impressions of the game were that it seems rather technical, like the waves, the programming behind the waves seems really technical and intensive, and the controls also seem fairly technical and require some precision that most players just don't have or aren't coming to it expecting to need. You know,
but
with
it's,
Matt
it's,
Hoffman, you could, you know, with any of these other games, I mean, it's understood that your character is going to stay on their bike or on their, you know, board or whatever, and they're going to do the tricks, and if you get the trick done before you hit the ground, you'll be fine. But in this, it seems like the way you land is really, really important, so if you land just, like, 10 degrees off, your guy's trick could be completely fucked, or you might just fall off your board, and it, again, seems really technical, which I think is a testament to how difficult surfing actually is, especially doing tricks while surfing.
Yeah, surfing looks,
it's
seems
insanely
like
hard
really
to do
hard,
in real
yeah.
life. Props to anybody who can do it well.
Yeah.
Props to anyone who can do it well in this game, too.
But I think they probably could have taken some of that technical stuff out.
Yeah,
that's just my opinion.
There's, you know, quite a few minor things as well. You know, like landing perfect has a really big emphasis in this game. Like landing pretty
and
much
getting
like
a perfect. You'll see it at the bottom.
Because your special bar will go way up. Whereas if you land like sloppy in other games,
it
that
just
wouldn't do anything.
The whole
in this
thing.
Game, it trains the entire bar. So even if you're doing special tricks, you'll be back down to like a fourth of your bar, and you'll lose all that.
Right.
So
you have to get into it's just a matter of getting into a rhythm. You know, the more you play it, the more you can judge perfect landings. Mm-hmm. I mean, after a few weeks of playing, I was able to get perfect. You know, 90% of the time.
Yeah, so play a little more, record a little more. I hope to do the whole game, but I think I know what you were going to spoil to me, because I also read the guide. So we'll see you next time in another Kelly Slater. I can talk about more things, we can watch more surfing, and I'll probably upload all the stuff that I cut out, you know, Kelly Slater's little introductions so to the levels, so you can see those too. And so, Kelly Slater, I hope you enjoy.
Take it easy, you guys.
Bye.